Hey guys, it's Jenna. Welcome back to my channel today. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you guys some super exciting new makeup releases that I just found out about and I can't wait to share them. There's some amazing brands that are releasing some awesome products coming soon. The first brand we're going to talk about is Natasha Denona. There's also some exciting products coming from Charlotte Tilbury, Tom Ford, Dior, Chanel, Hermes, so many luxury brands. So let's get right on into it. First of all, I do want to do a quick thank you to the three Instagram accounts that I follow for luxury makeup updates. They're the ones that provide these sneak peek pictures. So first of all, we have Trend Mood One. I'm going to link her in the description box. We also have Chic Profile Official, as well as Angel Naked One. All three of them are fantastic at what they do, and I do encourage you guys to follow them if you would like. Let's talk about the first one. The first one is Natasha Denona, and she is coming out with another mini palette. The palette I'm talking about is the Mini Zion palette, Xenon palette, I think is how you say that word. This is a very deep color story. I'm actually really excited. It's quite dark, quite smoky, has some gray tones, a beautiful gray shimmer tone in here as well. And it's very interesting. Like, it's just not bright or colorful like Circo Loco, Mini Zendo. She's definitely done something very, very different here. So very exciting to see this one. Do let me know your thoughts. At first I was kind of like, oh, it's dark. I don't know. I'm not sure if this is something that I would wear a ton, but I'm also kind of thinking maybe it'd be really beautiful for like some holiday events if you have a really beautiful gray smoky eye. More information about this is coming obviously very, very soon. It's just kind of postponed till fall, and it's also going to be coming with an eye crayon as well. So she's including an eye pencil with this collection. No doubt it's going to be a beautiful gray or maybe like a black. Who knows? But let me know your thoughts on this first one from Natasha Denona. Next, we have Charlotte Tilbury, and there are three sneak peeks of some products coming up. So the first one is actually a new Nudegasm Glowgasm palette. So I have to make sure I say that right. So if you guys remember, I think it was a week or two ago, she did this like random restock of the Lovegasm and the Lightgasm face palettes. I actually got a Lovegasm palette. I really wanted to get that second color story. Unfortunately, mine came with a blush that fell right out of the pan. When I showed you guys, I lifted it up and it literally fell straight onto the floor. I have white carpet, so that gave me like a heart attack. It was like this very deep, rich, rosy blush. People were kind of wondering, why is she restocking these? Some people are saying it's actually because she is coming out with a third color story. So this is called Nudegasm. It's going to be two shades of highlighter, one sculptor, and one bronzer. So it looks like one cooler toned kind of sculpting shade, a warmer toned bronzer, and then two highlights. Apparently the quality of this palette is better than the Lightgasm or the Lovegasm one. Very interesting, because I love the Lightgasm palette and I actually think the quality is great. So the Lovegasm 2, I haven't played with it too much yet since I just got it, but very interesting because it does say it's coming in September sometime. So I'm pretty excited about that. That is going to be a palette I'm going to be all over. The other sneak peek from Charlotte Tilbury that is coming out is she's coming out with two holiday quads. And this is actually a picture from Chic Profile Official. There is one that has a beautiful like peachy pink with some gold elements, and there's also a purpley one. It does have an interesting star design on the cover of these, and it does make sense why that would be holiday, because she does tend to do like stars in your eyes or starry eyes. She does like to do lots of stars around the holiday. And normally she also comes out with a 12 pan palette. So I'm wondering if this is going to be in addition to a 12 pan, or if this is going to be just her two palettes she's going to release. But the first one is called Celestial Pearl. The second one is called Cosmic Pearl. They're supposed to be new formulas, which is also really exciting. And Chic Profile did say, actually, now that I'm reading this more, she did say a new 12 pan instant eye palette will also launch soon. So that's super exciting that she's also confirmed that for us. All of us know it by this point that she releases a ton of pink, a ton of berry, a ton of gold, you know, like she's got her shades that she loves to do. So it's going to be interesting to see how much these shades differ from other palettes. I'll definitely be reviewing all of these for you because I know you guys are always so excited, but it's super nice to see a sneak peek on the holiday releases coming from Charlotte. Charlotte is releasing very, very soon. This is actually the end of July, July 22nd, on their website, a lip scrub. It's from their Magic line, and it's going to have sugar crystals for a gentle exfoliation, nourishing ingredients like jojoba oil, shea butter, cocoa seed butter, olive oil to leave your lips smooth. $28 American for this one. Let me know your thoughts on this because I think people are very mixed. I think that the biggest thing is that people think it's very expensive, which I mean, yeah, it is. Who knows, right? If it's going to be this outstanding lip scrub, it might actually be worth the price. But if it's just going to be something kind of plain Jane, then maybe it wouldn't be, right? So I will definitely pick this up if you guys want a review. Let's talk about Tom Ford now, and he does have two new quads coming in his eye color, like luxury quad formulation. The first one is called Metallic Denim. This is number 32. This is gorgeous, you guys. It has beautiful, like, blue tones. Obviously, you know, inspired by blue jeans or denim of some kind, right? I'm just gonna assume that's where it comes from. There's also one called Rose Prism with the purple and peachy pink. For some reason, even though he's done blue in the past with eyeshadow palettes, I feel like I'm more drawn to the denim one. But do let me know your thoughts. Chic Profile says that they're launching in Japan in mid-August, so I'm wondering if that's just going to be a Japan release or if it's going to also come to the US and to Canada and Europe and all sorts of other places. It does say that these are new palettes to him. They are not re-promoted palettes. There's also some more new ones coming down the pipe apparently that are not going to be in the wet and dry formulation that he's used to. Super excited about these as well, and let me know your thoughts too if you're interested in a review of these. Tom Ford is also coming out with a concealer. Now this is courtesy of Angel Naked One. This is the Shade and Illuminate Concealer. I'm a big fan of the Shade and Illuminate foundation. I do think it's one of his best foundations he's done. And this is the concealer kind of partner to that product. So I'm really excited. The packaging is exactly the same. I just hope that the shade range... pulls through, guys. That's the only thing. I just hope that it's wide enough so that enough people can actually use it and it's not going to cause any concern. Very, very interesting to try this one out too and just see how it compares, especially to the foundation that it's supposed to be in the same collection from. There's also a sneak peek of his upcoming Soleil holiday palette. So last year he did kind of like a cool tone purpley pink palette. It was like the Soleil de Neige, I think. This is Naked Pink. And it has some beiges, it has some interesting pink elements. It's very like everyday friendly. It's definitely a stark difference from last year's holiday. And it's interesting that he did this because the difference between last year's holiday and the holiday previous was pretty minimal. There wasn't a ton of, you know, differences when it came to colors. It's a little bit different, but not a ton. This is one that he really just went all out different for, which I appreciate. I think it's awesome to see some variety. But let me know your thoughts. I do love the white packaging that he always does for holiday. And this is the last Tom Ford new one that I can see here from my notes. Yes, we do have the Illuminated Blush Duos from Tom Ford. They're also coming soon. I posted these on my story because I was pretty excited for them. And you guys had some mixed reviews as well, which was very interesting to see. There were some people that were saying it's kind of a same old from him, and other people were super excited. There are 6 total in this collection of color stories. They're supposed to come in late July for us. Overseas is going to be in September. Interesting embossment in these powders. It looks gorgeous, actually, very luxe. Has TF in the middle there. Some color stories have more of a distinction between the shades, and some of them really don't. Just depends on how you want to use your blush. But I'm really like into this. I think I'm gonna try them. Let me know your thoughts on these blush duos, though, because I'm pretty excited for them, not gonna lie. Next, we have a new one from Hermes. Hermes is coming out with highlighters. I'm so excited. Okay, so the blushes, you guys know my thoughts on the blushes. I thought they were great, but I thought they were powdery a little bit, and for the price point, they were high. So it really is one of those products that if you want to support Hermes and their brand, is it my favorite blush in the entire world? No, but it is definitely a good quality product. I don't necessarily think that a ton of you guys were a big fan of the outer packaging, that you kind of expected more from them. What I like from them though is they do have that really nice, like it's like a powdery, easy to use formulation. So this picture is from Angel Naked One. It is the new Poudre du Ivre highlighter. Oh gosh, there we go. Love the French, but I hate how I sound when I say it because I know it's wrong. There's also going to be a release of nail polish with this collection. So based on her pictures, they look fantastic. They look like it's going to be the exact same outer packaging as the blushes. So that's going to kind of depend if you like the blush outer packaging or not. It's going to be very, very similar. But this is stunning. I love the embossment and the powder. It's got gorgeous, like, history behind the brand. There's that beautiful, like, horse and carriage. There's the H logo. I'm obsessed with that. I think that's fantastic. I can't wait to test them out, so do let me know your thoughts. But I love the embossment in this. I think it's stunning. We do have some new Chanel products coming, and this is super exciting for those of you guys that really like the Le Beige Skin Tint. Unfortunately, this wasn't a product that worked out for me. I just found it extremely sheer and the buildability was poor. So if you really didn't want a sheer base, it wasn't going to be for you, right? I still am interested in trying these, but I'm sort of not as excited about them because of my first experience with the skin tint. But these are actually gel blushes from that same line from Chanel. They're called the Eau de Blush Water Fresh Blush Blushes. There are four shades, it looks like, and they look quite watery, quite thin, very similar to that first product. Like I said, those swatches show me that it's very similar to that. There's kind of like that little bit of like capsule bits of pigment within the liquid. So once you blend them out, they look super, super beautiful, but it's going to be one of those ones that if you're wanting more of a sheer kind of wash of color, I'm just guessing that's what these are going to look like. Lots of companies have created blushes this year and expanded their lines, etc. So blush is definitely the hit so far in 2021. And I'm not surprised Chanel did this, but let me know your thoughts on this formulation and how you think blushes will fare with this Le Beige kind of water micro capsules formulation from Chanel. Lastly, there is supposed to be a limited edition quad celebrating Chanel number 5 and their perfume. Now, there's a lot of already some limited edition collective items that are celebrating Chanel number 5. I haven't actually seen them. I don't have a Chanel store near me, unfortunately. So I just kind of live vicariously through all of you. And there's been some interesting thoughts behind that, whether it was disappointing or it was kind of haphazard or it was very, very exciting for you. So this is going to be a limited edition quad. Unfortunately, not yet known which regions are going to get it or when it's going to be released. It looks to be a beautiful quad that has number 5 embossed in some of the shades and a perfume bottle embossed in other shades. Although the perfume bottle shades look very similar, they look almost like redundant shades. So it's gonna be interesting to see. Maybe there's a difference in texture there. Very interesting palette. I'm not sure how many of you guys are gonna be excited about it because it does seem to look, you know, like you're gonna have limited options for versatility with this one, just given that 2 out of the 4 shades look very close. Let me know your thoughts on this, but it is going to be a Le 4 Ombre limited edition quad celebrating Chanel number 5. We do also have some Dior releases. Now, Trend Mood reported on these as well, and I did get tagged a lot in this post. This is the relaunch of their highlighters. There are 6 new Forever Couture. Well, let me say that again. 6 new Dior Forever Couture luminizers. They are available now in Australia, but supposedly they're going to come soon to other countries. So they do have 95% natural origin pigments. They're supposed to blend easily into the skin. They do have wild pansy extract, natural hydration, and like I said, 6 shades. So there's pearlescent pigments with a multidimensional glow. They are not supposedly shimmer heavy, but they just have that pearlescent finish. So very excited to see what these are all about. It looks like they have that gorgeous, like, leathery packaging. I'm hoping it's not going to be plastic. It sort of looks like it might have that really soft, compact element to it. I'm wondering if they're going to be refillable based on that, but they didn't say that they're refillable. I'm just kind of wondering. So this will be a very interesting one. Not a lot of people think the shade range is very inclusive. So let me know your thoughts, of course, on these highlighters. Are you excited for them or are they an easy pass? He does tend to put out quite a few eyeshadow palettes in a given year. And the first one here, I believe, is for fall. It's the 5 Couleurs Fall Look, Birds of a Feather, I think is what it's called. And it's very beautiful with the feather embossment. I absolutely love that. It looks like there are 2 color stories here. One that has a beautiful, like, burgundy, silver, gold, and purple. The other one has blues, green, a bright peachy pink. So they're very fun for sure. I do like the embossment in them. I think, you know, attention to detail like that does get me as a consumer. I'm like obsessed with that kind of thing. Packaging, of course, is like just that extra little touch. But this is supposed to be the Five Cooler formulation in two new color stories. We also have the Atelier of Dreams collection coming. And I don't know if this is supposed to be for holiday or if this is just another collection that they're doing. Hard to say, but there are two eyeshadow palettes coming as well for the Atelier of Dreams. And they have a beautiful embossment too. There's a beautiful like deeper color story, one that's a little bit lighter. There's pinks, of course. This is gonna be, I think, more of an everyday friendly palette for those of us that wanna stick to a monochromatic look. Super gorgeous. There's a topper, there's shimmers, there's a matte in these. Really beautiful attention to detail for these two palettes as well. And the last item I'm gonna update you guys on is the new additions to the NYMPH family from Huda Beauty. The first product is the Glaze Skin Glowing Perfector. This is gonna run $35. There are three shades, it looks like. These are highlights. And then we have the Body Drip Shimmering Body Oil. Not gonna be interested in that, I'll be totally honest. I'm just not a body oil kind of gal, so that's just gonna be an easy skip for me. There's the Kiss Glow Blush. I think there's only one shade in that, actually. I can't see any others. And there's also going to be an All Over Body Glow. Again, it's like a highlight for the whole body. That's gonna be an easy pass for me as well. We do have some brushes that are attached to this collection, so most likely the highlight and the blush are gonna be the biggest draws for me personally. If there is anything, of course, do let me know your thoughts. Very interesting how the textures are with this kind of formulation. I think the big like rose compact is supposed to probably be that all over body highlight because it looks quite massive, right? Then we have that like other rose looking compact in the middle. And I'm wondering if that's supposed to be the blush because there's only the one shade. The highlights do have that same swirl that reminds me of the Chanel bronzer. That's like my favorite Chanel swirl. And Huda's got it all over her highlights. That's okay, it's not a proprietary swirl, I'm assuming. But I'm excited to test out those as well. If you're wanting a review, do let me know. I'm so excited to discuss all of these new releases with you guys in the comment section. And until my next one, guys, take care and stay safe. Bye, guys.